Sam here from Creative Minds. In this video, we're taking a look at a new plugin that blocks users whose domains have been blacklisted from registering on your WordPress site. This plugin helps you avoid unwanted spammers, viruses, and malware by blocking unwelcome visitors. The plugin uses several methods to detect unwanted domains, including SpamAssassin's constantly updated list of thousands of spam domains. You can also manually add domains to the blacklist or whitelist. The site administrator also has access to a detailed record of all failed registration attempts. So let's take a look at how this plugin helps you protect your WordPress site from unwelcome spam, viruses, and malware.
So before we get into the general settings, I just want to talk about the blacklist and the whitelist for a moment. So the blacklist is the list of all of the domains that will be blocked from registering on your site. And the whitelist is a list of domains that are allowed to register despite the fact that they've been flagged. However, you can also choose to only allow domains on the whitelist to register on your site. So it's really up to you. And here in the general settings is where you're gonna make that distinction. So as you can see here, we have the first option is accept domains only from the whitelist. So this is if you wanna really restrict who has access to register on your site. Then we have the use DNSLB domain service. So you can choose whether or not you wanna use this service. Next, you can choose whether or not you want to actually use the blacklist or the whitelist. The free domain list, so this is the list of nearly 3,000 domains that have already been identified as spam or malware. So next, before we head over to the user blacklist, I think it actually makes sense to look at the free domain list first. So this is a list from SpamAssassin. So this site is automatically finding these spam domains and adding it to their list. And then what this plugin is doing is pulling from SpamAssassin's list of thousands of these domains, and it's adding them automatically to the blacklist. So you can always update this list at any time. You can also whitelist domains that appear on this free domains list. For example, if you want someone from games.com to be able to register on your site, you can simply add this domain onto the whitelist. That will cancel out that domain from the blacklist, so people from games.com will be able to register for your site. So now let's head over to the user blacklist. So here you can add additional domains that you want to prevent people from registering on your site. This is in addition to or completely separate from the free domain list, depending on those general settings that we explored earlier. So for example, if I add cats.com, this means that anyone who tries to register with an email address from cats.com will not be able to register for your site. And we have a handy little domain tester in the plugin as well. So if you want to test to see if a domain will be accepted or not, you can go ahead and add that domain to the domain tester and check it. And as you can see here, because we blacklisted cats.com, the domain tester tells us that this domain is blacklisted. Now let's head over to user whitelist. Here you can add new domains to the whitelist, which would cancel out the SpamAssassin list. For example, we were talking about games.com. So if you take that domain, add it to the whitelist here, that means that when someone from games.com attempts to register on your site, they will be able to, despite the fact that that domain appears on the SpamAssassin list. So again, if we go to the domain tester and if you put in games.com, you'll see that this comes back as a valid domain for your website's email registration. So next thing we're gonna check out is the labels. So these are the messages that will appear when people attempt to register for your site, but for some reason they were blocked. If their domain is blacklisted, or if it doesn't appear in the whitelist, or the domain is in the SpamAssassin free domain list, you can create labels that appear in all of these instances and customize them based on what you want people to see and also what you are going to read in the registration log. So depending on the settings that you chose, different messages will appear. So now let's head over into the registration log. So here we have a list of all of the failed attempts at registration on your site. So this means that the domain is blacklisted, or the domain is in the SpamAssassin's list, or for some other reason, this person was blocked from registering. And you know exactly when that person or spam bot attempted to register for your site. You know the email address they attempted to register with, the reason for the failure, and the IP address associated with that registration attempt. So now let's take a look at what this actually will look like for someone who attempts to register with one of these blacklisted domains. For example, we're gonna do cats because we blacklisted the cats domain. And when this spam bot attempts to register, as you can see, registration failed because this domain is blacklisted on your WordPress site, thanks to our new plugin from CreativeMinds.
The Email Registration Blacklist plugin is an easy way to protect your WordPress site from spam, viruses, and malware by detecting blacklisted domains. Visit plugins.cminds.com to download the plugin today.